So, how'd the product test go?
Complete failure. I don't understand it.
Didn't it pass QA?
Every single part passed every single QA test, but the whole thing just doesn't work.
Well, how's that possible?
Quality assurance is an important step in any manufacturing process. In theory, it's where we confirm if everything is coming out the way it's supposed to. But passing QA may still mean part failure if the parameters aren't based on functional intent. That is, you can set what seem like reasonable tolerances, pass those with flying colors, and still have useless parts. Functional intent means considering a few key questions about your part. What does this part need to be able to do? What does it have to do in conjunction with other parts? And what tolerances will allow these two goals to be met? Metrologists ultimately conduct tests to determine the necessary characteristics for functionality in a product's final assembled form. The results form the basis for the measurand. The measurand is, on paper, a fairly simple sounding thing. The official BIPM definition is the quantity intended to be measured. But this doesn't just mean the part itself, or whatever specific metric you're looking for. It includes things like your target for acceptable margin of error, hence the intended part. What should this thing be if all goes according to plan? For a designer, this means the specification requirements. For a manufacturer, it's the thing they're aiming to make and how it should work. And for a metrologist, it's the target range of measurement values and the conditions under which they should be obtained. A lot to consider. Once the measurand has been decided upon, it's provided in the general part info. Part drawings like these list the measurand to help ensure that a part meets its requirements. Thus, we're not just measuring for the desired value, we're also aiming to meet specific tolerances and under specific conditions. All well and good, but how do we actually arrive at the appropriate measurand value in the first place? So, a useful measurand ensures functionality while an arbitrary set of tolerances might not. But what's the actual difference between them? Truth is that your chosen measurand doesn't guarantee final success, especially during the beginning of the design process of a new product. Instead, we find the right measurand through an iterative process with lots of careful testing throughout. Then, as we learn more about what works and what doesn't, we gain greater confidence that our product specifications do ensure a final functioning part. It's this precise and deliberate trial and error process that makes all the difference. Defining an appropriate measurand cuts both ways, too. Suppose you have a part that really needs to function, so you choose a ton of features to check and apply some tight tolerances to each of them. A part that passes all of that should work great, right? You inspect it, and it fails. You inspect another one, it fails, and another, you even tried using the part and it worked. How can a functional part fail? Just choosing a bunch of dimensions to inspect at random does not take functional intent into account. How many of those features really matter to a working part? How do they relate to each other? And how tight do your tolerances really need to be for your part to work correctly? You may even find that targeting fewer features is a better bet. These are the kinds of considerations that will help you define a useful measurand and hopefully put your work back on track. Generally, by designing, manufacturing, and inspecting through the lens of functional intent, we help reduce the possibility of failure and speed up the process of reaching our desired final product.
So, are you gonna fix this?
Yeah.